The third day of the filing of certificates of candidacy for the 2025 elections has ended. Let's get the highlights today from our correspondent, Ara Perez. Hi, Ara.
Hi, Ron. Good afternoon. This afternoon, Manila 1st District Representative Ernix Junicio filed his certificate of candidacy for re-election. Joining him are former Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, Chi Atienza, daughter of former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza. Moreno and Atienza are reportedly running for Manila Mayor and Vice Mayor. Here, Moreno was also asked about incumbent and re-electionist Manila Mayor Honey Lacuna, who said there will be no more room for a comeback, echoing her supporters.
Peace be with you. Hayaan ko na lang ang taong bayan sa Maynila ang sumagot. Ipepresenta lang namin yung mga nagawa natin at pwede pang gawin.
Meantime, former Taguig Mayor Lino Cayetano is aiming for a political comeback as Taguig 1st District Representative. He says he is also fully endorsing Taguig Mayor Lani Cayetano, who is reportedly eyeing re-election. Lawyer and broadcaster Attorney Virgilio Garcia, former Presidential Security Group under President Rodrigo Duterte, Francisco Palma, and independent candidate R.B. Bernardo aspire to become representatives of QC's 2nd District. From October 1 to 3, 31 lawmakers aspirants have filed their COCs here.
Thanks for the update, Ara. Leaders of Partido Democratico Pilipino, or PDP, are still trying to convince the Duterte family to add their names to the senatorial race. Party President and Senator Robin Padilla says they remain hopeful at least one member of the Duterte family will join their current slate. He adds they are in talks with former President Rodrigo Duterte and his sons, Davao City Representative Paolo Duterte and Davao City Mayor Baste.
Hanggang ngayon po, sa mga oras na to, kami po ay dinudulog po namin yan. Gusto po siya, hindi siya isa sa mga anak po. Kasi talagang para sa amin, napakahalaga sa PDP na may Duterte. Kasi ang PDP ay Duterte.
Philippine Senator Ronald De La Rosa admits to snubbing the International Criminal Court as he maintains it has no jurisdiction over him. During his filing of certificate of candidacy for re-election, De La Rosa said somebody from the ICC had already contacted his office. The senator, however, told his staff to ignore them. The court is probing the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs. De La Rosa is considered the chief instigator of that campaign as Duterte's former police chief. Official government tallies say over 6,000 people were killed, but rights groups are saying up to 30,000 lives were lost.
Senator Loren Legarda calling on the Philippine Statistics Authority to carefully inspect birth certificates of political aspirants. Our correspondent, Victoria Tulad, now on the line with the details. Victoria?
Hi, Denise. The Philippine Statistics Authority, local civil registries, and local government units should scrutinize the birth certificates of questionable individuals who will run in the midterm elections to prevent having another Alice Go in public office. This was the urgent call of Senator Loren Legarda in light of the possibility that more foreigners who illegally obtained Filipino birth certificates will file their certificates of candidacy or COC. She said some local civil registries are already issuing birth certificates to non-Filipinos who eventually are able to obtain passports. Legarda pointed out that many foreign nationals took advantage of PSA's late registration process. Legarda also called on the public to be proactive in reporting dubious personality. She also suggests creating a hotline or a social media page where the public can report foreign nationals who are masquerading as Filipinos. Together with Senator Raffy Tulfo, Legarda has filed Senate Resolution 1200 last September 17, urging the appropriate Senate committee to conduct an inquiry on certain local civil registries which issued birth certificates to foreign nationals through the late registration process. The resolution cites PSA information that there is, and I quote, an alarming number of discrepancies in birth certificate registrations, including 308 instances of fake birth certificates submitted for passport applications between January and September 2023. This practice poses a risk to national security, according to the resolution. As to the possibility of former Bambantarlat Mayor Alice Go running in the May polls, Legarda said the Commission on Elections, or COMELEC, must intervene and not allow this. The poll body has previously said, however, that their job is ministerial, which means they can only accept the COC unless a perpetual disqualification decision is slapped against Go. Legarda cannot say if Go is indeed a spy, as alleged by a Chinese tycoon-turned-spy interviewed by Al Jazeera in its documentary, but she said Go resembles one. Denise?
Thanks, Victoria.